We're here today as part of a larger movement taking back our democracy from the corporations. We're occupying Freedom Plaza right now in different parts of D.C. But it's all essentially the same issue. It's about taking back our Congress that's controlled by the corporations right now, and that's a huge part of the pipeline as well.
So taking it back, like, who would you put the power in the hands of, like, instead of corporations?
In the people. We need, like, a people's Congress. You know, we need to get everyone out of there and start fresh.
So how big is a corporation? Like, I know there are so many different sizes of businesses. Like, I work on a farm that's, you know, a bigger farm than other farms, but it's not like one of the evil mass farms that everybody needs. Like, where do you draw the line between a big evil corporation and, like a business,
it's whoever's like pouring billions and millions of dollars into our congressional elections.
And ours. So like lobbying?
Yeah. Whoever's like putting in like to me, it's the big corporations. It's not
Not
the little businesses. Yeah. Things
so
like well, not like Slyndra.
Why?
I don't understand the Slyndra thing actually.
It was a huge corporation. Well, I'll just tell you briefly history. Like,
yeah, it seems like they defaulted
business
on their loan, right?
Yeah, they were going bad on their loan, but it was a big business that got money.
Yeah, not that much though. And like you got to look at people like ExxonMobil who are, you know, lobbying really hard inside right now, and these corporations who have put billions and billions of dollars into climate change denial, while all across the world there's no debate about whether climate change is happening. You go anywhere else in the world, there's not a debate. It's a debate they've been able to create in the U.S. because they have sponsored politicians in Congress.
Okay.
And so it's more like, especially dirty energy. I mean, companies like Linda are not like, you know, putting, you know, making record profits like Exxon more than any corporation in the world.
But like financially, do you think that was smart of the government to give them that much money?
You know what? The government gives subsidies to oil companies like candy, and they are making record profits across the country. So something like that is just fodder. Is fodder.
So that's just like a water in the bucket. So like 535 million is just a drop in the bucket.
You know what? You know, you hold that up to the way they bailed out the banks and where the amount they give. The government gets way more money in oil subsidies every single year, and they have for a really long time, and that it actually still is a fraction. Yeah. I bet Congress for that. Yeah. But when you look at the money that's given to coal and oil and natural gas utilities, like, that is actually just water in the bucket. That's how scary it is. That's how much money is exchanged between the government and...
Do you think it's wrong for the government to give money to any company?
You know, right now I'm much more concerned with the money that is not given to the government, especially by the wealthiest corporations who avoid tax loopholes
But that's like giving money to the government. What about like the government giving money out? Like, is that okay in general?
I don't know how to answer that. Hey, how are you doing? Companies and our Congress and how they're able to do anything they want in this country, and they don't pay a dime in taxes. So I think everybody has to pay taxes, and I think that they should be held accountable as well.
Well,
but yeah, thank you so much. Who are you guys with?